Take a look at the picture that you can see on the screen. Now, you must have gone to the railway station at some point of time in your life. Now, if you would have looked at the railway tracks closely, you would have found certain gaps in between the rails. Now, when you see the railway tracks, do you think they are made up of entirely one piece of iron? Or do you think there are separate pieces? Obviously, there are separate pieces which are known as rails. Now, these rails are placed one after the other and then they are riveted. So, when these rails are being placed, there is a gap in between the rails that is intentionally provided. It is not because of any fault or breakage. So, can you tell me why such a gap is intentionally provided in between rails? We shall soon find out the answer to that. So, first of all, let us consider a very interesting and intriguing experiment. In this experiment, a simple apparatus is considered, a ring along with a ball. Now, initially you see that the ring is allowing the ball to pass through it. Now, notice what happens when the ball is being heated. As you can see, initially, the ball passed through the ring very easily. Now, gradually the ball is being heated, and it will interest you to find out what happens next. You will observe that once the ball is being heated and taken to a sufficient or adequate temperature, it is again attempted to pass through the ring that was previously there, the same ring that was initially used. So now see what actually happens. The ball is heated and again passed through the ring. Now, if you look closely, you will find that the ball is no more passing through the ring that previously it passed through, because the ring hasn't been changed. Now, see what happens when we cool the ball after dipping it in a beaker of cold water. Again, we find that the ball is passing very easily through the ring without any difficulty. So, why was the ring obstructing the ball when it was heated? So, we can explain this with the help of a concept that is known as thermal expansion. So, what is thermal expansion? The expansion of a substance on heating is known as the thermal expansion of that substance. So, when the ball is being heated, it is getting bigger in size, or in other words, it is expanding. So, initially when the ball was cool, it passed through the ring very easily, but when we heated the ball, it underwent expansion, which we call thermal expansion, because it occurs only on heating. So, once it underwent thermal expansion, it increased in size, or we can say that the diameter of the ball increased, and as a result, it was unable to pass through the ring that it could initially pass through. So, the phenomenon of expansion of a substance on heating is known as thermal expansion. Now, let us find out why thermal expansion takes place. Consider the kinetic model of matter. Over here you will find that the medium particles initially are vibrating to and fro about their mean positions. Now the instant heat is being supplied, the temperature of the medium particles is increasing. So when the temperature is increasing, what happens as a result? The kinetic energy which is dependent on the temperature is also increasing, and thus these particles are vibrating vigorously to and fro about their mean position. That is, the velocity of their vibrations is increasing. So, the moment the velocity of their vibrations increase, they collide more frequently with one another and they have a tendency to take up more space, because kinetic energy is also dependent on the velocity of the particles. So, when velocity increases, the kinetic energy increases because of an increase in temperature. So, when they collide more with one another, they have a tendency to take up more space and expand. So, this is why thermal expansion takes place. Now, look at this picture. You must all be knowing that any given solid has a definite shape. Your book has a definite shape. The glass from which you drink water also has a definite shape. The table at which you have your dinner also has a definite shape. So, we can say that all solids have definite shapes. Now, in this particular solid that is being shown over here, it has a fixed area, it has a fixed length, and also a fixed volume. So when we heat a solid, it is going to expand in every aspect. Or in other words, we can say that it expands in all directions. A solid, because it has a definite shape, expands in all directions. And as a result, the length, area, and volume, all three increase on heating. Now let us find out which aspect is affected more under what conditions. So initially, we are heating a very, very thin wire. You will notice that as and when heat is being supplied, the length of the wire is gradually increasing. Now this is happening because it is undergoing thermal expansion and the length of the wire is increasing. Now because it is a very thin wire, the increase in its cross-sectional area or the increase in its thickness is negligible. We can say it is almost not present. So we are considering only the expansion of length. So in such a case, it is known as the linear expansion of a substance, when the expansion being considered is only the length of the material that we have taken. Let us consider a second scenario where a thin plate or a sheet is being heated. Now, as you can see, when this thin sheet is being heated, its surface area is gradually increasing. But the increase in the thickness of the plate will be negligible. Why? Because it is a very, very thin plate, as I have mentioned, that is being considered. So in this case, we are considering only the increase in area. Such an expansion is known as the surface or superficial expansion of the plate, where only the surface area is being considered. Now let us say we have a solid cube that is being heated. Now when a cube is being heated, we find that the entire cube is increasing in size. Now a cube has a fixed length, breadth, as well as height. So when the cube is heated, the length, breadth, and height, all three will increase. As a result, it leads to a total increase in the volume of the cube. So in this case, when all three quantities, that is the three dimensions, are perfectly noticeable and not negligible, it undergoes an increase in volume. This kind of expansion is known as cubical or volumetric expansion. So thus, we see that there are three kinds of expansions which solids undergo. The first we learnt about is linear expansion, when we are considering a long and thin wire. The second that we studied was surface expansion, when we are considering a very thin plate or sheet. And the third is volume expansion, when a cube or any body which has a fixed length, breadth, and thickness is being considered. So these are the three kinds of expansions that a solid can undergo. So we have seen that solids have a definite shape, that is, a definite length, a definite breadth, and a definite thickness. So in case of solids, if we consider a thin wire, we can consider linear expansion. If we consider a thin sheet, we can consider surface expansion. And if we consider something which has a definite length, breadth, and thickness, we can consider volumetric or volume expansion, because solids have a definite shape and volume. Now, in case of liquids and gases, you know that these things have no definite shape. So, can we consider linear expansion and surface expansion? No. In case of liquids as well as gases, we consider only volumetric or volume expansion. Why? Because these liquids and gases have no fixed shape, and they take up the shape of the container in which they are kept. So the amount of liquid poured in or the amount of gas poured in, that will be the amount or the volume that has been kept inside the particular container. And its shape will also depend on what container it is being kept in. So at the end of the day, we cannot consider linear expansion or superficial or surface expansion. The only expansion we consider in case of liquids and gases is volumetric or volume expansion. So now let us go back to our original question. The question that I had asked is, why do you think there is a slight gap that is present in between these two rails? Now these gaps which are present in between successive rails, as I told you, is not the result of any fault or breakage. It is intentionally kept in place. Now let me tell you the reason behind it. In summertime, the heat that the earth is getting is very much. So as a result, these rails, which are made up of metals, namely iron, gets heated to a great extent. Because these rails get heated, their temperature rises, and as a result, they expand. Now, because these rails are fixed with the help of these rivets, they expand in a linear fashion. So now, tell me that if there was no gap present and these rails would have expanded, what do you think would have happened? These rails would have gone one on top of the other, or they would have gotten deformed. And as a result, at the junction in between two rails, there would have been a deformity. So any train that would have passed through those rails would have undergone derailment, and it would have resulted in sufficient amount of disaster, and loss of life might also have been incurred. So in order to avoid that disaster, this gap is left so that these two rails can expand within the gap that has been provided. And the gap provided is always sufficient so that these two rails do not get deformed on expanding. So when a train passes through these rails, obviously it will not undergo any derailment and it can pass safely through. So taking a quick recap, we learnt about thermal expansion. That is the expansion a body undergoes when it is heated. We learned that solids undergo three types of expansions, namely linear expansion, when a very thin long wire is considered. It undergoes surface or superficial expansion when we consider a very thin plate or sheet, and it undergoes volumetric expansion or volume expansion when we are considering a cubicle or any other body which has a definite length, breadth, and thickness. We also saw the reason why there is a slight gap left in between these two rails to allow for greater expansion. And we learned that liquids and gases do not undergo linear expansion and surface expansion. Why? Because liquids and gases have no definite shape. They take up the volume of the container, or they take up the shape of the container in which they are kept. So that is why liquids and gases only undergo volumetric or volume expansion.